What is up, world? This is our brand new show, Blow the Whistle. Now, what Blow the Whistle is a series of opinions and or point of views about what we dislike and find or have a problem with. And I'm Damon.
And I'm Angel.
And we are DNA, DNA Productions. And today's episode, we start off with horror movies.
Ah, hope we get those.
Horror movies, yes. We all know about those horror movies where you got a group of kids, usually teenagers, being retarded and going around getting killed by crazy white people. Now, we have found to be a pattern amongst these movies.
Seems to happen in like every movie.
It's just constant. It keeps coming. It keeps going. And today we're gonna break them down. And take it away.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as you watched and as you've seen, there are plenty of horror movies for teenagers. Let's just start with that. Teenagers, like first of all, I think these are like the perfect actors for these movies because not only are teenagers stupid, they're new to the world. So I'd just like to start with the order. Well, first of all, one pattern I've seen, of course, is the black people. Then you have your smart people. These people are probably the ones who will die early only because they're smart. And the killer thinks, oh, maybe if I can take these guys out, I can take out the rest, which is basically true.
Never be a hero.
Don't.
You will always die.
You will die. And then you have your couple who has sex, or is about to have sex. And then you have your couple who goes into the forest or any other factory or warehouse or wherever they just have sex. Usually starts off with the guy dying first and the woman.
Do not diverge from the group.
Don't.
Especially to have fallacious relations in the jungle. That's a no-no.
Yep. And I believe there's also the people who are actually stupid and making fun of the killer. These have to be my absolute favorite in these movies. These people will just up front just make fun of the killer and either get their head chopped off or stabbed in the back. Which is kind of ironic since, you know, they're just being too upfront. But basically, I'd like to start off with the black people, because I think there's some kind of misunderstanding about black people dying in movies, and I think we need to clear that up.
Yeah, okay. So, you got the black people in the movies, and everyone expects that they're going to die first. For reasons beyond me, I don't know if it's racism or it's just hilarious. I don't know. But I'm about to break it down. Okay. You know, you don't really see too many black people in movies now, you know, and you don't even really see them dying, you know, first in these movies. However, the thing that gets me is just the fact that the black people die in the most ridiculous ways possible, the most ridiculous ways imaginable. You got, you know, Samuel Jackson in Jurassic Park getting eaten by the dinosaur because the crazy white people gonna screw up the computer. And then you got, you know,
Deep Blue Sea.
Samuel Jackson in the Deep Blue Sea getting eaten by the shark when he was making that noble speech about how we're gonna beat the shark and save the day. But no, black man can't get any credit. He can't be the hero. Oh no, fuck that.
Wait, here comes the shark. LL
Cool J is not Samuel Jackson. Samuel Jackson can fight some snakes, but goddamn it, he cannot fight a damn shark. And then, you know, to keep the train rolling, we got, you know, Samuel Jackson again in Goodfellas. You know, he's in the scene, he's sleeping, and then here comes Joe Pesci beating on the door just to wake him up, and he's tired, and then you're gonna kill him when he's putting his pants on. I mean, what kind of bullshit is that? I mean, Samuel Jackson deserves, you know, a proper death, you know, not being shot when he's putting his socks on. But, you know, I would even rather, you know, I was fine with Samuel Jackson dying in Star Wars Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith, when, you know, the lightning, the white guy shot him out of the window with the lightning. You know, Samuel Jackson gave his best, you know, Mace Windu in that purple ass lightsaber. I don't know why they gave him purple lightsaber. It's a purple drink. I don't know what the affiliation is, but I think there's something that we gotta read between the lines.
I mean, a great freaking lightsaber. It's great flavor,
yeah, right? You got Kool-Aid lightsaber. Of course, they give it to the black man. You know, and then you got Samuel Jackson once again, you know, in The Other Guys. I know it's not a horror movie, but, you know, that pissed me off. I thought, because Samuel Jackson is one of my favorite actors of all time. You know, he's entertaining, he's funny, he's hilarious, and he can be serious at the exact same time. Now, I thought him and The Rock were going to survive for, you know, a good portion of the movie. You know, they didn't even have to die. I wouldn't even care if they just disappeared throughout the movie. They'd have to kill him off. But it wasn't even like 5 minutes into the movie where these two dumb niggas jumped off the building and killed themselves for no reason. And then I know the writer was white. I know he was white.
Had to be, right?
It had to be, because they know ain't no way black man gonna kill off Samuel Jackson in the beginning.
I guess to get the niggas off the way.
That's a good way to get half the audience in the theater to leave. Okay, I would have left. I almost turned it off.
I mean, just black. That's why.
But, you know, I mean, I just don't understand how Samuel Jackson can die in all these movies, but then you got Busta Rhymes in, like, Halloween, and he survives to the end.
And he makes fun of the killer. I'm gonna go into that shit.
Yeah, and he makes fun. Yeah, but if he was in the next one, oh, Lord, if he was in the next one, he would've got his ass. He would've got his ass in the beginning. But, of course, you know,
Samuel Jackson.
It's Samuel Jackson. We think it's funny for him to die. Maybe. One thing you notice is, you know, like I said before, there aren't too many black people in these movies, in these horror movies anyway, and that's just because maybe the film industry has realized that, you know, black culture is just a little, you know, smarter.
Maybe. It's been proven.
You know, in these kind of situations, you know, that in terms of black people running, as Cedric the Entertainer put it, black, you don't ever hear about, you know, a group of, you know, 10, 11 bros getting killed all at once because all we do is run. I mean, how you gonna die when you run?
I mean, when we see trouble, we get the hell out of there. Just like he explained in one of his stand-ups, we run, the white man's standing there asking questions for like an hour.
But yeah,
I mean, we out of there already.
As we're running away, here comes the white man, you know, what the heck's going on? And, like, you know,
exactly.
He gets knocked the fuck out.
When I see some fucking animals going that way, I follow.
White man
goes this way to go check it out.
And ain't no time to ask questions when you're getting shot. That's bad. Some sugar, but man, look what you got on right now, boy. Get him.
Mighty, if it ain't the fucking Mighty Ducks in
there. I said, get him.
Look at them pants.
I cannot believe with those boots. Oh, you know you ain't got no laces.
Please take off that mask so I can swipe it right now.
I swear to God, if I wasn't crippled right now,
look at them shoes.
Oh my God.
Right now.
I cannot handle this. I cannot believe this.
Get out of here, man. I just
swear to God.
But so seriously, though, we need some sugar.
Thirsty as hell.
Yo, man, you got some sugar?
You gotta think in these situations. You hear there's trouble, you run. You don't ask questions while we running. You don't hesitate. You just
get
run.
The hell out of there.
You haul ass and get the fuck out. You know, you don't even look at anybody. No, you get the fuck out.
When the plane is leaving, get the fuck on it.
When you know there's a killer on the loose, and you know where he's been, you know where
Camp
he used
Crystal
to live. You know, yeah, Jason, perfect example, Camp Crystal Lake. You know, he died there. Who in the right mind and knowing he's still out there, would go back to Camp Crystal Lake and then fuck.
Naked and you're having sex.
And then, yeah, and then yeah, your hormones, the two raging, even hearing boots coming in there. And
all he has to do is knock on the damn door and stab you.
And it's funny because, you know, his like hiding spots, they always like under the bed or like in the closet or, you know, places that you should, you know, expect a killer to be. He might be at the window. He's just chilling.
Just saying, and then you gonna open it. Let me get some air in here, honey. Let me just see this.
And then here comes the knife. You know, exactly. You guys are idiots. And